Right, hello everyone, and welcome back to the show again. So let's get started. All right, so sorry, today I'm actually a little bit late. I know the market is actually open, just like maybe 3 to 5 minutes. But in any case, let's just focus on what has closed yesterday. So as you can see, yesterday actually bounced back a little after dropping. So the upward trend definitely still remains in the towards the upside, this overall trend. In terms of the market structure-wise, what I see is a low, a high and a higher high, a low and a higher low. So market structure has definitely transited back to a bullish market structure. Trend wise remains bullish, and the strength of the trend wise is currently normal, because let's see over here, you got 2.9, 2.3 and 2.6. yep, so it's still not aligned nicely, as you can see over at the top over here in terms of the moving average when I point over here. So yep, that is the current situation. And if you have entered this trade setup, like I mentioned, I will still stick to it. Otherwise, I do see another potential setup, which is basically, you can see over here, there's a potential that you could consolidate, say maybe for today or even for tomorrow. And thereafter, if it breaks to higher high, you can consider a long setup with a stop loss below this low over here. And the target will be similarly over here, over this, right below this red color horizontal resistance. So yeah, that's an alternative trade that you could go for if you have yet to enter a trade. Otherwise, yeah, that's the update for this. If you look at the price action wise, yeah, tendency that is going to consolidate here is there. But alternatively, it could also actually fall below. So yeah, so which is why I say if you have yet to enter a trade, I wouldn't enter right now, because your risk to reward would not make much sense until you just break above, then the possibility or probability is in your favor. All right, so let's move on to Nasdaq. Okay, over at Nasdaq, yes, again, made an all-time high once again, not the 8. So not on the 7, which is yesterday. This is yet to open. Okay, so Nasdaq opens a little bit later, but otherwise, if you can see on the 8, it actually close to even an all-time high once again, which is why I say that it's best to actually use this trailing stop loss, and I will use this 20 exponential moving average as the first guide. So market structure clearly remains bullish, both in terms of the strength of the trend wise is strong, and also the trend is very much above the 200, 150, 50, and even the 20 exponential moving average. All right, so if you yet to enter a trade, I wouldn't suggest taking any trade for Nasdaq right now, because it's really looking overly strong. All right, so next up we have for the ASHR, which is basically the China equivalent in terms of the S&P 500. So in that respective, yes, once again, make an all-time higher high over here. And now that yes, open is even make an even higher high. So for me, I don't see it as some sort of like a trading potential, because right now the momentum is too strong, and there isn't much of a reasonable place to put a stop loss. If you were very aggressive, you could actually enter upon here, which means the break of this high, and with a stop loss right below here. So this is the potential that I could see to the next horizontal resistance. That will be the target profit area. But to me, this is way too aggressive, and I'll prefer to see some sort of a consolidation over here than a breakout before I enter a long setup. So that's my personal preference and from my experience wise. Okay, so in terms of the market structure wise, obviously it's still making higher highs and higher low, bullish market structure, bullish trend, strength of the trend wise definitely strong. And yep, and let's move on to KWEB. Okay, for KWY similarly, it has made an even higher high. So right now it's really in quite some sort of like a euphoric kind of state, because you can see this thing is going, and this thing is like spiking up almost like exponentially. So here the slope, as you can see, is already quite relatively steep, but it still sort of obeys this 20 exponential moving average. But now this thing has gapped up. So I do expect some sort of retracement. How far I can retrace is quite uncertain. I'll definitely wait for pullback before entering any new trade or even investment wise. Okay, so market structure clearly is bullish. Trend is bullish, and the strength of the trend is also strong. All right, Lastly, let's look at Bitcoin. In terms of BTC, what you see over here is actually a high and a higher high. So clearly right now it's still in the bullish market structure. And in fact, over these trades I have actually entered, but I'll explain more later. So strength on the trend line remains strong and it remains bullish. Okay, it may not remain strong because it's almost going to cross over, as you can see over here. But let's just point away and take a look. So 8449.3, yep. So tentatively right now, the strength of the trend remains strong because this 150 still remains above the 200. But it could very much likely actually falls below. That is where the strength of the trend starts to become normal, which in other words has weakened. So when things has weakened, it means that the tendency for it to be to fall towards the downside is there. But that doesn't mean that it has to fall. It just means that it could possibly do so. All right, so let's move on to the 4-hour chart and I'll explain why I actually entered the trade. So where this trade set up, what I mentioned, as you can see over here, yesterday was there. So what happened was basically broke over these 200 simple moving average, and that's where I actually entered the long. So the very first candle it broke over, I actually entered above the break of 9,004. And I'm in this trade now. So right now I do see potential consolidation as long as it remains above this 200 simple moving average on the 4-hour chart. I lean towards the bullish side. It could attempt a false breakdown before it goes up, in which case I may be stopped out. So that's the risk I take by having a tight stop loss. But the problem is if you actually choose to have a wider stop loss, you may not be stopped out, but your risk to reward will not be there. And which is why statistically speaking, you have to stick to either a tight stop loss or a wide stop loss or reasonable stop loss that you do stick to on a regular basis, because over time, false breakout don't happen all the time. So if you're always taking this wide stop out, you may not have the much profit in terms of the reduced risk to reward setup. So that's the kind of consideration you have to take into that's the kind of factor you have to take into consideration as well. Okay, so in terms of the strength of the trend line, it's definitely strong. You get 200, 150, and 50. So it's strong. In terms of the market structure-wise, like what I mentioned, it's definitely in the bullish market structure and a bullish trend. So even though this is strong, but it's actually not a strong bullish trend, it's actually a strong in a bearish manner. So there's, in that sense, the contradictory and the irony behind it. So like what I mentioned, I already entered based on the pullback. And it actually was a breakout from the pullback, the long setup. So entered upon 4K, target will be 9.62. Yeah. Yep. So that's it. That's the main setup that I'll be looking, that I've already entered, and I'll stick to my risk to reward setup. Otherwise, I'll see you guys tomorrow for the quick update and a summary. Yep, for the quick update of today itself. Otherwise, take care everyone. And if you have any questions, as always, feel free to leave down your comments below or your feedback. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye-bye.